Do you sometimes return merchandise to vendors that you purchased on account? Well, then you need to know how to record returns to vendors for on-account purchases. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When we return items to vendors that have been billed, the effect on the accounts is the opposite of entering the original bill from the purchase. The document that you make when returning items that were billed on account is called a vendor credit. Then you must apply the vendor credit to the original vendor's bill. So what happens in the accounts when we return items that we purchased for credit? Well, obviously, inventory asset goes down for the amount that we paid for the items because if we're physically giving back items to the vendor, we have less inventory. And because the vendor's balance is reflected in accounts payable, we owe the vendor less money if we return some of the items. So both inventory asset and accounts payable will decrease for the purchase cost of the items that were returned. For example, let's imagine on January 9th, we returned 3 apples to Addie's Orchard from the January 4th bill, number 8472. So let's just go ahead and make a vendor credit for that. It's very simple. We click New in the top left, go to the column of vendors, and go down to where it says vendor credit. Now, filling out the vendor credit is the same as filling out the bill. We put the date of the return, we choose the specific vendor, so that's January 9th for the date and Addie's Orchard for the vendor. Now remember, we're not dealing with expense categories, so you can click this triangle and collapse this. We're dealing with items. So click the triangle to open the items section. Then under where it says products and service, click here and choose apples. And we are returning 3. And since we paid $10 each for the apples we're returning, QuickBooks knows the amount of this vendor credit is $30. We click save and close. And now when we click reports, and we go to the trial balance, you can see that inventory asset, if you double click inventory asset and go to the bottom, the very last transaction in inventory asset was January 9th. It was a vendor credit in the amount of $30, lowering the inventory asset. Click reports, go back to trial balance, and you can see accounts payable has also decreased from 500 to 470. And you could open that up and see here was the original bill for the 500 and here's the vendor credit lowering it to 470. Now let's click reports, inventory valuation detail, and you can see for apples at the bottom section of apples we have 3 fewer apples as a result of this vendor credit, lowering the money amount and quantity that we have of apples. Now you also have to check the unpaid bills report. Click reports, unpaid bills. Now I don't want to get too sidetracked into the accounts payable section, but basically this is the bill and this is the vendor credit. Now, the unpaid bills report should not really show both the bill and the vendor credit. It should put them together and show you one remaining amount of 470 for that bill. What you have to make is what's called a $0 bill payment just to be able to apply this credit to this bill. Now, this is something you learn more deeply in the accounts payable course, but I just want to show you because it is part of inventory. You really should apply the vendor credit for merchandise to the bill for the merchandise. So we will make a bill payment on January 9th. The amount will be zero. We will simply apply these two together to make the unpaid bills report look the way it needs to look. Click New, go to Vendors, and click Pay Bills. Now, make sure it says January 9th, the day that you actually made the credit. And on the day, okay, so we already have Addie's Orchard up here because that's the only unpaid bill we have. And it's a little unusual how you apply the credit. You have to click here, and then you have to apply the credit here. Notice it already knows that there's $30 of credit available for Addie's Orchard. So as soon as you do that, as soon as you click this bill, it will apply the credit. But be careful. When it applies the credit, it assumes you're paying the rest of the bill, and we are not yet paying the rest of the bill. So please change the payment amount to zero and make it so that all it does is apply the credit to the bill. Save and close, and now the unpaid bill report looks the way it should. $500 was the bill, but the open balance now, unpaid, is only $470.